So, hello, I'm not Sally Audent. I'm not going to talk to you about UX invaders. We come in peace. My name is David Tisserand. I'm a user researcher at Ubisoft Montreal. Sorry, another one. We are a lot, so probability are that you're going to meet some. What I want to say, yes, I'm also the Gerzig chair this year. So you all know what this is. Okay, so I just wanted to give you a quick update on the SIG. I'm not going to take a long time, so I leave enough time for a lovely keynote. Okay, first things first, I want to thank again our sponsors for making this this event happen. Without them, again, nothing, we wouldn't be able to share knowledge all in the same room like that. It's quite amazing actually to see how it's grown from like 6 years ago, 40 people in a room, and now we've got this amazing facility. Thanks Sony for that, and all these other things like the drinks tonight, and everything is basically paid by our sponsors, so thank you very much. Other people I want to thank as well are our volunteers. We are a non-profit, we are part of the IGDA, and basically all the money we make, we put it in the summit. And all the people that work on the summit, and that's a lot of people, let me tell you, they give their time, a lot of time, to make this happen. And it's very important. I mean, again, we wouldn't be here without them. So again, big thanks to all the volunteers who've contributed. And also a big thanks to our speakers. Again, we wouldn't be able to share knowledge if there was nobody to share knowledge. So thanks to them too. We had great talks again this year. It's awesome. I hope you guys were as inspired as I was, despite their bad French accent, like Florian and me now, So it's okay. It's okay. Represent France. That's good. Cool. So what I want to say, yeah, that links me to the initiatives we've got this year, which is the whole point of why I'm on stage now. So basically, there is another summit happening in London. I think it's in July. You guys have seen the flyers now around. Basically, they need the same thing that this summit needs, right? So I think they're sorted for sponsors and volunteers, but now what they need is speakers. So if any of you have things that, today you feel like, wow, that's great, but I can also talk about something, which is a bit related, or actually nobody talked about that I think it's very important. Feel free to give them, send your proposal, basically. If you go on the LinkedIn page, which I guess you're all in the LinkedIn group, basically you're going to see where to post your content. Another initiative this year, and it's great. I was talking to a student just 5 minutes ago, and so there are two initiatives that are really geared towards students. One is the mentoring program. So I don't know if you heard about it yet, but you're gonna during the year. Basically, it's a way to link senior people with students, basically, and that's headed up by Kirk Rogers, which is somewhere here in this room. Again, go on the Gerzi group. You're gonna see some information about that, and hopefully that's going to help to, there is a word in English for that, but basically close the gap, between when you're studying and you really would like to be working on Dragon Age or whatever, Far Cry, with some mentors. So we also need mentors, by the way. So all the faces I recognize here, we have been here for a long time. We need you too to help these students. So please feel free to volunteer a bit of your time. Another one that you might have seen on the posters is the job board. So it's brand new, actually. David Milam was spearheading that. So it's the first time we've done it. We've done it a bit late. It's brand new, right? So we're going to iterate on that. And the goal here is to for all the people working in the industry to show what jobs they have open, and for all the students maybe, or even experienced practitioners who are looking for a new jobs or a new company, to basically be able to be linked together. Okay. Next thing, Maggie did a very good job this year as well with finally putting together this wiki we've been talking about for years. So I hope it's going to be a useful resource for all the students and everybody, not only students, but people like, working in QA who wants to start a user research career, like it often happens. What I wanted to say about that, yes, so same thing, they also need senior people to help contribute, to putting some content there. So it's basically populated with all the awesome tools we've got to make research. I want to thank Sam Long too for the Twitter initiative, so he's taking care of, there's another word in English for that, but making sure that basically there is some content and retweeting everything related to games user research. So it's now integrated in our website, but yeah, you can just follow games user research now on Twitter too, which is great. The online library is still there, it's still alive. I see lots of academics putting new content on it as it goes. If you go again on the Gerzig LinkedIn page, page, you're going to see a link for that. And basically, you see all the last papers, basically, in games user research. Again, academics, when you're publishing, do not hesitate. Whatever you're doing, it's important that you share it with the community. So please put it in the Mendeley Library. Final thing, the website. So you might have seen our gamesuserresearch.org website, which actually historically was just for the summit. This year, we're going to redesign it. So we're going to have a website for the summit, a dedicated one, like you can see on the Games User the EU summit website. We're going to have basically a copy and paste of that for the US summit. And the gamesuserresearch.org is going to become basically a big hub with basically all the tools that I'm talking about. So you don't have to go back in on the LinkedIn page and try to find a good thread where they are all the links. It's going to be all in the same website. We're going to put lots of content there. Seb Long, again, got the idea to share all the pictures we've got about our lab setups, these kind of things. You're going to see all the videos from all the summits, et cetera, et cetera. Final thing, I hope I'm not going over 10 minutes. Sorry, I talk a lot sometimes, but this final thing. You might have seen that we finally passed the 1,000 members this year. I just want to say that it's not 1,000 members that just, you know, arrived on LinkedIn and said, oh, I want to be part of this group. We're actually selecting the people that come in. So you've got to all work in games, all work in user research to be accepted, basically. Roughly, there might have been other criteria, but it's roughly that. And 1,000 people, like, selected is quite a lot of people. And it's amazing, again, when you see how it started, you know, like 6 years ago. Thanks, Bill Fulton, for that, by the way, to start that thing. It's great. Now, one thing that I would like to ask you to do, and I won't force you, right, but it's a volunteer organization. And sometimes we see, like, for example, when we vote for the steering committee every year, so we vote for the people who are actually steering what we're doing and what we decide to do or not, like the mentoring program, like the job board, like all these things. Last year, we had 48 people voting for the steering committee. So meaning that basically it's not very a democracy. It's just like the 48 people that just maybe know more or something like that. But it's not really the community voting for the steering committee. So what I'd like you to do, if you can, is just make sure that you set up your settings basically on LinkedIn so you receive at least the weekly updates. Obviously, I'm crazy about the SIG, so I'm receiving them every time somebody posts something. But you don't have to be spammed by that. If you do a weekly update, then you're going to at least every week receive like, okay, this is what happened in the Gersi community this year. And maybe you're going to see that there is actually something happening, like we need to vote or, you know, this kind of thing. So I'd really appreciate if you could do it and raise this bar maybe to 10% of our community next year. That would be great already. So that's it, yeah. Sorry if I took too much of your time, but I'll let Celia talk now. Thank you.